Speaking
are
of
you men?
Are you single?
Yeah, are you single, Scarlet?
Are you single? That's the next question.
Are you single like a Pringle?
What the f*** is going on?
I like to party.
Jesus, honey, wax much?
This is Unwaxed.
Get in, loser. We're going shopping.
With Sophia and Sistine Stallone.
Did we just become best friends?
Yep.
Everybody, and welcome back to another episode of the Unwaxed Podcast with your favorite sisters,
Sophia
and Sistine
and Scarlet.
Woo! Woo!
That's right, baby. I'm back.
You guys.
Reunited.
It's so crazy. First of all, as you could tell if you're watching the video version of this podcast, we are not in our usual Unwaxed studio, and we have the pleasure of Scarlet Stallone joining us today on the podcast. So therefore, we are shooting back at our old studio in Florida.
I'm so excited to be back. Also, we are all under the same household again, which is even crazier.
I know. Yeah. It's really nice.
It's been a while since all five of us have sat down at dinner together.
It's really hard being away from you, especially for me. I mean, I don't know how Sophia feels about it, but I...
Yeah, I don't care.
Yeah, Sophia doesn't care.
Yeah, of course I care.
You guys are together 24/7. You guys are together.
Right, we're together all the time. So it's really nice to not only have you to break it up, but you're like my little best friend. I want to put you in my pocket all the time. And the only way we can communicate today is through FaceTime. So
yeah.
Luckily, we're good with that.
And I don't even like FaceTiming because every time I FaceTime you guys, I start crying. And then every time I see you again, like we reunite and it's only been a month, but it feels like 2 years. I literally start bawling in your arms.
You know what? I like seeing you cry for me though. Is that weird?
You like seeing me cry?
Well, no, I like
some odd satisfaction.
Well, it just means you care so much.
Oh, yeah. Because I don't show
that's what
that
I'm saying. Scarlet
affection.
Doesn't show
any affection
emotion
at all.
Yeah.
I don't
so
show
I
any
feel
emotion.
Loved. I like it.
I know.
Yeah.
How's it been back here with all of us together? Is it overwhelming or do you like it?
You know,
do you like having space?
Well, since I've moved across the country for college, I've just... You know, I'm really social, so I can make a lot of friends. I can distract myself, but that's why I hate calling or FaceTiming you guys or seeing your faces because I bottle all of that up and I get so emotional because we've grown up so close together all the time. We've done everything together. So even talking about it right now makes me emotional knowing that I'm going to leave in 2 weeks.
I definitely want to get into your college life, how you're adjusting, living away from home. How about this? For the people that don't know who you are, we're going to give you a little bit of an intro. And I think we'll do some rapid fire just so people, you know.
Ease in. Get to know me.
Yeah,
I would like to know you guys,
slip right
too.
In. All right. So our guest today, you've already been introduced. We're doing it again. Our guest today is making her third appearance on the Unwaxed podcast. You are the number one requested guest, by the way.
Wow.
There's more actually, than mom and dad.
Did you guys ever see the DM that has been sending every single day since Scarlet came on? It's been like 150 days. And the guy says, until you bring Scarlet back on, I'm going to keep writing this.
So you could stop DMing us about that because everyone absolutely loves you. So you're back for the third time on the Unwaxed podcast. You are known for always having the aux cord and sleeping in till 3 p.m. We have college student, aspiring actress, and annoying little sister, the fabulous Scarlet Stallone. We love you so much.
Yeah,
should we talk about what went down in our living room the
other day? Oh my God. I mean, that was probably the most slow-mo tragic thing to happen in a long time.
It was definitely not a Christmas miracle.
No, it was a Christmas tragedy. You guys, I don't know if you, when you watch our mom on the show, you probably see how loving and affectionate and definitely when you see that woman, you're like, she probably brings a lot of holiday spirit.
She puts so much effort into this time of the year.
And that's, and especially since the five of us are all together. So she's going the extra mile. And so recently, we'll just kind of give a little spiel in the beginning. She bought this tree. It looked like a giant bush. It was like the ugliest Christmas tree I have ever seen.
Yeah, it looks like she cut it down herself.
Yeah, and she showed us on FaceTime and I remember all of us going, Jen, like, where did you get this? It was, like, literally a shape of a ball.
So, I know. She was so excited when she FaceTimed me and I was in college sitting in my dorm and she FaceTimes me. So girl, look at my tree. I go, Mom, that is hideous.
It looked like a pom-pom. It was all trunk, no brush coming out from it.
Yeah.
And just a tiny ball at the top.
It didn't make any sense.
So sad.
And this woman made it her mission to physically, like, cut it off with scissors, shape it like a tree, put as many decorations and ornaments. And she's had these ornaments for years.
25 years.
25 years. Since very young. Like, I've seen the same friggin' Santa that stands next to our Christmas tree since I was a little girl. And so she really, you could tell, put her heart and soul. And so when we came into town, we're like, oh, this looks a lot better.
It looks beautiful. Mm-hmm. So Sophia Scarl and I are sitting in the living room.
There's presents already under the tree,
yesterday,
by the way.
Yesterday. Okay. And right, there are presents under the tree. It was oddly windy outside. And we're renovating the house. So there was a tarp covering the wall behind the Christmas tree. Someone opens the door. A huge gust of wind pushes the tarp, therefore pushing the tree over. And it literally looked like the most dramatic movie Christmas holiday fail you've ever seen.
Can I say, we had time while the tree was falling over to look at each other and look back and go, no!
Oh, it was like a bad car accident. Like, you wanted to look away, but you couldn't. And you just heard the shatters of hundreds of ornaments just break.
All of that. All of my mom's work. All of the years she's had with all of those ornaments.
She was devastated.
Done. And not only that, the tree was, it's a real tree. So it had water underneath. Water went all over the presents mom wrapped. So the paper was soaked and all the presents were starting to come undone. And so you basically could see like 90% of the presents.
You'd lift a present and literally water would be pouring
Scarlett,
out of
it. Did
you
see her face when she first walked in?
Oh my gosh. It was the sad. It literally looked like someone shot her dog. Yeah. It was the saddest puppy dog face I've
ever
seen.
Well, we tried. So, but she wasn't home yet. So we call our dad and we said, hey, Sly, look what happened here. He goes, don't tell your mom. Don't tell her. So we bring people in. We try to push it back up. We're tapping it dry. We're trying to blow everything. We're trying to make it less obvious.
Glass everywhere.
She comes in when we're probably 80% done, but it still looks like absolute shit. And
I just felt so bad because I'm one of those people when something uncomfortable happens, I start laughing. But I didn't mean to laugh to be rude. I just was laughing because it was so sad.
We just couldn't believe what happened.
It was funny. It was kind of funny. You have to admit it. We'll laugh about it in a couple years and she will too. But then when I started laughing, mom got so mad at me. She was like looking at all of us and I didn't mean to be rude. It's
we were all laughing because I think it was more so that
of course.
It was not because we were like, this is hilarious. The tree fell. Mom worked really hard. It was that if anyone's tree was going to fall, it was going to be ours.
It was going to be our tree. Okay, so why don't we get into you, Scarlett?
All right.
We asked the listeners on our social media to ask you some rapid-fire questions just so people get to know you a little bit better. So I'm going to start firing those off.
Okay.
And you answer.
Great.
All right, Sophia, why don't you kick it off?
Scarlett, what are you studying in school?
I am in the School of Arts and Sciences studying BFA Musical Theater. And BFA basically stands for, if you don't know what that is, it's Bachelor's in Fine Arts. That's what I'm studying.
She does ballet. And to see Scarlett do ballet, I have live videos of her recorded on my phone. It's so funny.
Generically, you'd think a ballerina is very petite in physique and very short and flexible. And you are very tall. And you had to sort of learn your flexibility. So it's kind of like you're the anti-ballerina.
I was, because it's such an intense program. And the only way you are graded in that class is if you actually improve. And it doesn't matter if you're bad or not or anything, because kids, majority of my class is all really good dancers. I couldn't touch my toes in the beginning of the year. Now I can bring my leg up behind my
I still can't touch my toes. That's very impressive.
So I had to work really hard to work on.
And so we'll get into school schedule and what the BFA entails. But the next question is, any eyeliner / eyelash recommendations? You do the perfect cat eye. Which
do I actually?
I was going to say today. Pretty good.
I've never
been complimented by my sisters on my makeup because I've never been good at makeup.
I remember we FaceTimed you when you were in the beginning of college.
Oh, Scarlett.
Scarlett, can I just say, I'm going to just say it right now.
I don't want to
hear
your
makeup was horrible.
Scott, I was about to fly to your college and rip those strip lashes off your face. One was on your eyebrow.
And then one was, okay, so if you guys have seen strip lashes, one was by the end of her eye where it was going down. So one's all the way up.
You look like a Tim Burton character.
I was never good at makeup and I really wanted to improve myself. I kind of wanted to be different in college and try new things. and strip lashes.
You look busted. Well, I think you were wearing, because you were very not into the whole strip lash thing. But I think a lot of girls in your dorm and your year were doing that at your school. So yeah. You were just sort of doing it to fit in, right?
Yeah. I wasn't doing it because, you know, I kind of walk to the beat of my own drum when it comes to any kind of trends or mm-hmm. anything. So I don't follow along. But when it comes to going out to parties at night, like college parties and stuff, I would want to go overboard and try something different and experiment with makeup.
Yeah.
And strip lashes, absolutely not. I'm never doing that again. I will do like individual lashes, the CVS store-bought ones from like Kiss.
So that's what your recommendation is. You just stick those
the
on the
little
end.
tiny, they're not even strip lashes. They're the
individuals.
The individuals.
By the way, it's okay because my freshman year, my makeup was horrible
too.
So it's a learning
thing. I'm just happy that I learned now. Now I know. It didn't take me years to find out.
Yeah, you're lucky. Good. Sophie, you got the next question.
What movie or TV show character would you like to marry, Scarlett?
It could be a cartoon, too.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, no cartoons. No. Wow. I started walking.
No.
The Ratatouille. I don't know if I would want to marry a rat. But,
whoa. He can cook.
I don't...
Oh. Coco!
The first person I can think of is Thomas Shelby from Peaky
Blinders.
Oh, I know.
Very nice.
That is the first person I can think of.
All right. So staying on brand, the next question is, what is your type? A lot of people asked this question. What is your type?
You guys are going to completely disagree with me, and I know exactly what you're going to say my type is. But I know that my type is anyone that I just get along with.
Okay.
Someone that can match my personality. Okay. I don't really care about looks. I wouldn't complain if a tall Australian, 6'6" tall
man
walked through the door. I wouldn't mind
if some tall Amazonian man that is tan with an accent came
brunette,
up to me.
Preferably walk through the door and say, hey, and have a great personality. I wouldn't care.
So you basically just described
your
type.
No. That is not my type, though. I'm just saying.
Accents. Obviously,
I've
Thomas
found
Shelby,
myself
Australian.
Falling for people that are completely random looks. Like, I don't really care what they look like as long as we just bounce off each other. Because I have a very aggressive personality.
So what about personality-wise? Because personality-wise, I'd say that you lean towards more guys that can banter with you, which is a very high energy guy. Because some people
high
don't
energy,
like
energy, like a Leo, someone that's dominant.
That's astrology terms. If you guys
and,
know what that means.
Yeah, someone that's dominant and loud and can handle my personality.
Hmm. So speaking of Leos, are you men? Are you single?
Yeah, are you single, Scarlett?
Are you single? That's the next question.
Are you single like a Pringle?
Because she said she's into Leos, specifically. Loud, confident.
It kind of sounds like you're describing someone very specific in your life.
A very particular person that we probably know about.
No, I'm not single.
Oh my God! We did not know that!
Who knew?
Got you guys at home. Wow, so you are in a relationship.
Yeah. I started dating him a couple
months?
No.
Oh, a couple weeks.
We were seeing each other for a couple months and then officially made it official. Mm.
So I know you guys probably want us to ask more questions about this boyfriend.
But we will later.
All right. Someone asked Scarlett, have you ever levitated before?
Thank you, Dua Lipa. I have.
Okay.
Wait, what?
Someone actually asked.
Levitated?
Like float? Obviously, this girl over here has never levitated.
Next question, though. Okay. I literally told
Sophia,
you.
Come on.
Oh, favorite.
Do your job.
Favorite Christmas movie.
Oh, we were just watching it this morning. The Holiday. I just made my whole family watch The Holiday because with Cameron Diaz.
Unbeatable.
So
literally
unbeatable.
The best.
So good.
Favorite makeup item.
Actually, I was just using it. I have it on right now. It's the Tarte Juicy Lip. In the color kind of reddish. I'm obsessed with it. It feels like silk on your lips. I will 100% recommend this product to anyone. Thank you, Sistine.
It looks good on everybody.
It looks good on everyone.
I just tried it
today. It feels good. it just doesn't, it doesn't crease. It's like a lip gloss, but a lipstick at the same time.
Mm. Well, Scarlett, wearing that juicy lip gloss, if you were going to fight one of us, or wait, who do you think you can knock out first in a boxing match, me or Sistine?
Yes, yeah, Scarlett.
Yeah, wearing the juicy lip gloss. I don't
know. You guys are fighting. Both very strong. Very strong.
Oh, God. My arm looks so tiny.
I know. No. I just flexed. The thing is, look, you guys, look, are this, so... Look at this.
That's... Do you see that?
Boom.
Honestly, I think you guys could both beat the shit out of me.
Oh my.
I don't think I can win between either of you.
At least you know your place in this family.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. All right, Scarlett, what is your fashion inspo? Again, you're getting a lot of makeup, fashion type questions because I think you have a really unique style. So mm-hmm. What is your fashion inspo? Where do you pull from? Pinterest, Instagram?
I follow a bunch of models and I think their street style is so good.
Do you have one in particular that you want to name?
No, I don't. I usually just follow kind of what mom wears a lot too. Mm. Not what she wears now, but what she used to wear back then. I have a lot of photos like of her style.
And from like the 80s and 90s.
Yeah, the 80s, 90s. Yeah, I kind of just follow whatever I think just looks good and comfortable on me. I don't really have someone. I kind of just do my own thing.
Love that.
But I do follow a lot of Pinterest stuff too.
Okay,
Pinterest is a lifesaver.
I love Pinterest.
I do too. Anything with like runway or anything.
You know what's funny about Pinterest though? I'm almost embarrassed to admit that I have a Pinterest because I feel like it got uncool.
I love Pinterest.
But no one actually admits to using it.
I know. The last time
No one admits it, but people, when you say that you use it, everyone uses it.
I personally think the content on Pinterest is much better than Instagram.
Oh, 100%. I have a bunch of like Instagram or my friends that have really good style, and I usually just kind of copy them. But Pinterest, I think of it as me using it in sixth grade during school.
Yeah.
But then now I've come back to it recently and it's changed my style. It's actually helped me.
Well, I don't think there's anything else like that out there. Think about it. Is there any other app that you can read, like download photos, and then they would come up the same type of style that you're interested in one way or the other? Yeah. I think it's
like, I just know that I will never wear something that makes me feel uncomfortable, or if I don't feel confident in it, I will have a shitty night. Like if I don't feel good in something, I don't care what other people say about my style or anything like that. I will wear whatever I want.
What do I always tell you when you call me and say, do you like this outfit or what should I wear tonight? What do I always tell you?
Whatever makes you feel good.
So wear whatever makes you feel good. Even if it's a pair
of
jeans and a white tank top.
She goes, you can wear a damn sweatshirt. Whatever makes you just feel comfortable and good in your own skin, wear it.
Well, I just was reminded by you. Have you guys seen that TikTok that a lot of people are doing where it's like confidence is everything? So girls will kind of like look not that attractive on camera. And then the moment this one line in the song comes on, they pretend that they have this like exude like this confidence to be sexy.
Yeah.
And suddenly you're just like, they look 10 times hotter.
Yeah. Because you sometimes I think we let the outfit wear us, but if you're wearing the outfit, it's going to, you know,
totally
present completely differently to people. Okay.
Completely. Okay, Scar, who is meaner, me or Sistine?
Looks like.
Outwardly, Sistine. Sistine's a lot meaner.
Yeah.
What? I love you. I love you equally.
But yes, Sistine, I completely agree. I totally agree.
Sistine's a lot meaner because she's that person that if she can diss you and then you diss her back, she goes, are you kidding?
Yeah,
and gets pissed off. And I love you for that. I love your fire. I love your passion, Sistine.
She can't take it.
But
I'm sensitive.
I know you're sensitive. That's why I ignore it. That's why I kind of just smile and just wave it off. Don't get mad back.
So funny.
Fair enough. All right, Scarlett, if you could, someone wrote this, if you could grow another body part that you already have, what would it be?
Oh my God, why did I just think of boobs for a second? Why did I just think
about four?
No, I just thought of boobs.
That's for too a many.
Well, that's your first answer, so we're moving on with that one.
Oh God!
I'm trying to think what I would want. Another one. Maybe like an eyeball? Like in the back of my head?
That's really gross.
That's eerie.
That's gross because if you're brushing your hair, you're going to go straight.
Oh, that would hurt. Yeah, what would you put? That's actually, I wouldn't want another arm because then you're going to have to figure out clothes.
I would say another toe or something. So no, I can just cut it off.
Wobbly.
Okay, another finger. I'll just cut it off.
What if it keeps growing? You have to keep it on.
Yeah, it has to stay on.
Ooh! Ah!
Mm.
Maybe another mouth can be.
So you don't have to eat in front of guys because some girls get very nervous about
eating a salad. No, no, no,
that's actually a fair point. Some girls get very nervous about eating in front of guys, so they can just put the food behind their neck.
Like I said, you like you don't want to smoke in front of people.
or quite literally when you're talking behind someone's back, you really are talking
behind someone's back. Don't talk. I can't help it.
Oh my god, okay. Ask the next question.
Okay, how has it been being away from your best friend in college?
Oh, I gotta say, Charlotte, I miss her so much.
She's Charlotte.
You guys they both know my relationship with Charlotte because, you know, they are together 24/7 and they moved out together and everything. So Charlotte was like the one person I had who basically lived with me. And we all kind of consider her family. So being away from her is the hardest thing possible. Mm-hmm. It's just like I treat her like a sister too. So whenever I FaceTime her, I get very emotional.
So you just have to keep in contact.
We keep in contact every day. Oh, we try to call each other every day. You just gotta, it's not even hard. If friendships are that strong, you can go weeks and days and weeks without even talking to each mm-hmm. other. And just when you rekindle again, it'll be all the same. That's how you know it's a good friendship. That's how you know.
I have to say, a lot of friendships that you have in high school and especially people you meet in college aren't ones that are going to last much farther from that education that you had. But when you do find a good one like Charlotte, it's really important to keep that relationship strong, especially when you're not in the same zip code.
Yeah.
Shout out Maya. Love you.
Shout out McGab. Love you, girl. Okay. After the first week, maybe 2 weeks, did you feel a little bit more acclimated to the school or did you still feel like you couldn't fit in entirely?
I was, you know how just like every other college student, they're all trying to fit in. They're all trying to find their people. So I was feeling the same exact way. I started with a huge group of girls. Half of them, I didn't even know their names, but I started with a huge group of girl group. It was cool and all, but then the group started cutting down more and more throughout the weeks. But this is the time where I was feeling really, really uneasy with how I felt and how I fit in college in general. Because after that whole orientation thing, I just felt weird there. Mm-hmm. I was being stared at. Every time I walked by like a table or something outside, I would hear, oh my God, that's her and this and that. And I go, I'm not famous. I'm not famous. I don't deserve this fame. I'm the daughter of someone who's famous, but I'm not famous myself. And that's what really bugs me because I don't deserve this attention and I don't deserve all these looks and stares and people talking about me when I'm literally 2 feet away from them. So I felt really out of place, but it wasn't until the girl group really cut down to a solid 4 people. I had a lot of bumps in the roads with girls and whatnot because that is college. You're going to go through. It's kind of like a big high school. That's what I think of it. I mean, did you think your college experience was kind of like a high school?
Yeah, I did too. I mean, I had kind of a similar thing too with like the whole dad thing. I mean, it's
it was not even just the dad thing, but did you kind of feel like college was like high school a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, like I only left the school with probably like 5 really solid good girls.
Well, I think that's what everyone can relate to no matter what school you go to. Like even when you started a new workplace, you're going to try to fit in with everyone at the office or everyone on your floor.
Yeah.
And then you realize that, you know, sometimes the friendships that develop the fastest aren't always the most genuine.
Yeah, that's friend. It was a girl group that started way too fast, way too comfortable getting right in. And I just didn't like it.
It happens. And then it gets kind of complicated because everyone's then trying to branch off and they get closer with some people than other people. And it definitely is like a high school drama.
Yeah. And the real friendships will happen organically, naturally. You'll gravitate towards the people that you will like, that you know you like, but it will just happen. So when a couple months later, after finding a good girl group and everything, I had a solid like 4 or 5 really good close girlfriends that I had. And then I made a bunch of guy friends as well on top of that. Just a lot of friends in general that I actually like being around.
So it sounds like you're acclimated quite well at this point. But I remember mm-hmm. the first week that, you know, after we dropped you off, and I would love to get into the feeling of that. But after we moved you in, Sophia, myself, and my mom all helped you move into your dorm. We unpacked it. We cleaned it. And then, you know, we left, and that was the last time we saw you. The first week for you, I remember, was really hard. And there were a lot of emotional phone calls and a lot of you saying, I don't want to be here.
Yeah.
So describe what the first week, totally being alone and independent, without any parents, without any siblings, what was that like for you? And living with a complete stranger.
Yeah, well, I'm so thankful for my roommate. She's the easiest person to live with.
That's important.
We got along with each other very well. And just talking to your roommate, just for a piece of advice, anyone that's going into college, really talk to your roommate about cleaning-wise, this. You guys are living together for a full year.
Mm-hmm.
So talk about groceries and this and that. Talk about people that you're bringing over.
Specific.
You have to get very specific yeah. because you guys are living in a 10 by 10 bedroom with literally our beds are so close we can hold hands.
That's
so
crazy.
It's crazy. So you have to really communicate with them. So she was great. So that's what made me feel a lot calmer. But I think it was just me going into school, not knowing anyone. And I'm that person where it's like, if I don't have someone and I don't have someone to talk to at the school or someone to go to meet up with, I start panicking mm-hmm. because I always need to be with someone.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that's not a great trait and I need to learn how to be by myself because I am very independent, but just I felt so alone. It wasn't that I missed, no, like not saying I don't miss you guys,
no.
but it's not like I didn't, I wanted to be back with my mom, dad, and I wanted to go back. I just think that I wasn't in LA anymore. I moved across the country. I had no friends. We moved in the middle of my senior year to across the country, like I said again.
It was a lot of change.
So it was just so much change for me. And I think that I also personally didn't like the school as much as I thought I was going to.
Yeah, that's normal.
At first. But I think that, you know, a lot of college kids can relate to that too. Not
Every
knowing.
College kid can relate
yeah,
to that.
Like they go to the school and they're like, I don't know if I belong here.
Well, it's like, and it also, you never want to force something. If you're not happy where you're at and you give it a full year,
mm-hmm.
you can always transfer and change. Like you yeah. shouldn't force it. But the most important thing that you did and I'm happy you did was you really tried to invest yourself and acclimate yourself as best as you could because
mm-hmm.
you did want to give it a fighting chance. Like
yeah.
you never should take a place and not give it an opportunity because you never know who you're going to meet. Because look at now, although you, whether or not you like the school still, you have a boyfriend, you have a group of friends, so you still like your roommate, and your parents are kind of close by-ish, but it's still like, it's good that you did, I mean, try in the beginning.
No,
like,
it's
as
always,
much
you
as
have
it was
to
hard.
Try. You have to. If you just give up fully, then you'll fall into a deep, dark hole of sadness because you do not have anyone around you. You will push the people that you
yeah.
like away from you. And that's what I saw myself doing. I felt so alone. And every time someone reached out to me or anything, I would feel, I pushed them away. I was being rude
yeah.
because I didn't trust anyone at the school. I have really bad trust issues and I didn't trust anyone.
Well, I don't entirely blame you for not trusting complete strangers. Of course, everyone is going through the same feelings and they're in the
yeah.
same position in the same boat as you. They're all alone for the first time. Did you expect independence to be so difficult? Like, I think you're very strong and you've always been a very independent kid, but you've always had us to fall back on.
Mm-hmm.
So the fact that we're not physically with you for you to fall back on, do you find it really hard sometimes to have to solve things for yourself and figure out your way to go on your own?
Yeah, completely. Because now I know that all my mistakes that I make, and I've made a lot of mistakes, but I know that with the freedom of independence that I have, not having anyone to fall back on, I've made a lot of mistakes. And I truly, truly know that I have to sit back by myself in the dorm and deal with it by myself. And it feels weird not going into one of your rooms and crying to you
mm-hmm.
about it. Or not going to mom and talking to her. Or not having dad there 24/7. And it was very scary. But I've always loved to have the independency of my life. And
mm-hmm.
what everything I do. And I feel like that's grown me. I feel like I'm a stronger, better person now, and got I've been a lot more mature.
I love that.
Because I made so many mistakes and I had to learn and deal with it by myself.
And one thing I actually I want to acknowledge is you're doing a major that is very different from anything I've ever taken. And oh, it's a lot different from most majors, because when you're in BFA, from if people don't know what's involved in it, Scott can give you more of it. It's a lot of singing, dancing, acting, theater work.
It's it's approximately 11 classes, and
which is a lot.
I don't know if I'm gonna do it next semester, but I do know that I wanted to study and learn how to perform in every different kind of way. Which, so I can do anything.
Because you love acting. Now. You want to act.
I love acting.
But theater is a different
It is a whole other technique. It is a whole other technique that I've never been introduced to.
So for people that don't understand what, Sophia, I'm sure you can shed light on this. How many classes would a normal college student take?
Like, what did you do?
I would say you can take 16 units, like 4 classes, 4 units, you know, or you can take more, like 16 to 20 units.
So Scarlett's is significantly higher than
So my normal. Schedule is 11 classes in total, 23 credits a semester.
That's a lot.
That is a lot. That is so, my friends don't see me throughout the week. The whole entire week they do not see me because I'm constantly in class and doing homework and working my ass off.
So how are you able, Scarlett? I mean, that's really hard. You're a freshman at a new school. You're trying to make friends. You're trying to get to all your classes and do well in performing. How are you able to balance your social life with your school life?
Having a social life, it is very, very, very important. There are days where I just do not want to get out of bed. The whole weekend, all I want to do is sleep and stay by myself. But what will that benefit me for anything? Being trapped in classes all throughout the week and then on the weekends just stay in my room and not do anything and not make friends. The thing with college is that you have to be the one that you have to reach out. Yeah. It's every man for himself. No one's gonna just come up to you and just try to kiss your ass and be best friends with you. That's not how it works. That's not how life works. You have to be the one that makes the connections. You're the one who has to push for relationships.
Yeah. She said that's not how life works.
No, it's not. I realized that because I pushed myself away from everyone, I said before. So, I believe that having a social life and balancing school life is very, very, very important.
So the way that you went about it is you sort of forced yourself out of bed during moments that you could have easily just
stay
isolated
in.
Yourself and stay in. See, that's interesting. I was actually reading something really interesting the other day. And I think this applies to all three of us, especially applies to our mom, is how we handle stress. And I think, you know, all the time we are stressed out and we're complaining about this. But then I looked up this article and it said, are you addicted to stress? And I was like, that's interesting. Who would want to be addicted to being stressed out all the time? Because it's a scary feeling. So I wrote down some of the signs that show if you are addicted to stress. And I'm going to read them off. And you guys let me know if any of these apply to you or if all of them apply to you.
I'm going to put my fingers down. Okay. Fingers down if I feel that way.
You feel guilty when you try to relax.
All of us.
You have a hard time getting into the holiday mode.
Yep.
You don't know how to do nothing.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what to do with myself.
You often feel irritated. You think the reward will be greater if you suffer now.
Mm-hmm.
You have a hard time disconnecting at night. Big yes.
Yes. Oh my gosh, it is so hard.
And the last one is totally all of us. You boast about how busy you are.
Oh my. I talk about my schedule to my girlfriends all the time at school. They're probably so annoyed by it.
We need to seek a therapist about being stressed. We're all so stressed.
We're so stressed. You know what? It's not even that. I think we just all love overachieving. But the problem is like you have to have a balance. Like you can't just be on this high stress all the time.
But you know, when you have sort of a role model of someone that is showing you what a good balance looks like, that would be easier. Mm-hmm. But both of our parents are such overachievers, workaholics. So we only know that.
And it's not like they're pushing us to be that way.
No, it's just
they
what
actually
we know.
Tell us to slow down, but we don't like to slow down. And
we can't. We were raised like that. I remember when I was so stressed. It was one time. It was after a long day of classes. It was after five classes one day. And I was fine. I worked from 9 a.m. and did not stop until 5:30 p.m. And I look in the mirror and I'm wearing a tank top and there were hives all over my chest. And what was the first thing I did? I took a photo of it and sent it to you. Yeah. Because I wanted to show you how stressed I was.
Actually, I have a question. What is each of your things that you now know you're stressed that your body does? Like for me, it was funny. Like I, for example, like Scarlett said, her body, I literally said the other day, I'm getting all these bumps on my hands, like on my knuckles and my fingers. Stress. And it's like, and every time I get over like a level of stress, I get all of these random like red bumps. And it looks so gross. And no,
I have
two.
My chronic eye twitch that you listeners know very well at this point.
So gross.
And often sometimes when I'm sitting, I'll jolt my body and I'll shake.
Yeah.
And I've learned that that is signs of stress and anxiety. It doesn't mean you're cold.
I know. Mm-hmm. I have a problem when I'm super stressed. It's actually not that good. I dig my nails into my palms.
You do that.
Because all the time. And it just numbs me. It helps me. I shouldn't be doing that. And then I also get very bad breakouts. I mean, not hives all over my chest. And I can't sleep at night. I would wake up just sweating at night.
Well, I have to say, when you sent me the photo of your chest with hives, the first thing I thought was, oh my God, are you living with bed bugs in your dorm?
Yeah.
I really thought
that
actually,
is a thing. That's a thing.
And because your dorm, I'm not gonna lie, was a level of nasty.
So
that it's hard
gross.
To describe. But you somehow judged it up very well. And you actually were telling me some really interesting dorm hacks that you did to sort of made your living situation livable.
Yeah. So the first thing I did was my roommate. This is why it's really good to communicate with your roommate and talk to them about this, because my roommate knows that I'm a clean freak. She knows I get mad about like if there's trash anywhere so always take out the trash. Do not leave it because it will smell. It will stink up your room. Do not get any Do not get any too much fresh food and leave it in the fridge unless you're going to eat it the next day. So sometimes it stinks up the room if you leave
like
for at least a week.
Or like microwaving.
Microwaving. Yeah, that's another thing. But my roommate loves like the... She loves Indian food, Trader Joe from Trader Joe's. So
fire.
She loves it.
It's fire.
It's
so
good.
So she loves it.
However, so it doesn't smell... It smells actually pretty good in our room sometimes with food-wise. But I always get these... But I'm very sensitive with smell. So I get... You know those car fresheners that you put on
the clips?
Yeah, those clips that you put on like the air vents. Mm-hmm. Or not the air vents of your car.
Yeah,
Air vents. I clip them all over my air vents. So I have about four clip-on Febreze air vent things. So our room always just smells fresh.
Smells like ocean breeze.
Because you could be the neatest person ever. It's just for some reason that building is so
musky.
Old, musky, and... Oh, also getting a Swiffer sweeper, because I'm not joking. I don't know where this dust comes from.
It comes
I
everywhere.
Dust and vacuum our rug.
You know, dust
every
is your
day.
Skin.
What?
Yes.
Dust is your
no,
skin.
No, it's not.
Well, some of it is.
Yeah.
It better be some because I cannot be producing that much.
But you know what, Scarlett? You're doing it well and you're making situations work. And
oh, here goes.
I think
Ready?
It's really fun. That yeah.
Dust is
it.
A mix of skin cells, hair, clothing fibers, bacteria, dust mites. Bits of dead bugs.
Oh, I just got chills.
Soil.
That's disgusting.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
So just letting you know that's what you're cleaning. You just can't see it. It just looks like white things. And yeah.
Ew.
Now you know.
My God.
God, I'm surprised not all my skin's off the amount of dust that's in my room.
Yeah. So wrapping up the whole college talk, I guess the final question really is, do you see yourself staying at the school you're currently at or would you prefer to transfer?
You know,
it's a loaded question.
Some days where I really like the school because I'm having a good day and I'm having a good day with my friends and I'm looking at all the people that I met that have been so nice to me and have been so good to me, and I will miss them so much just knowing the fact that I'm not going to be with them next year. But at the same time, I find more days where I'm sad and I just want to transfer back to the school I originally was I got into.
So but, you'd like to go back to California?
Yeah.
Well, I would personally love if you came back to California. Yeah,
because it's a hard situation because I got into this my dream school in California for fall semester. And I was planning on going there since eighth grade. I've always wanted to go. And then just plans changed, moved across the country. But however, I am very grateful that I moved.
Yeah.
And I did something completely different. I've been in LA my whole entire life.
So you wanted to try something new. And you're like, why not?
I got into the great program and everything. And, you know, I've learned so much. Just being across the country and living on my own. Being there completely on my own. And it's just a whole new atmosphere and everything. So I'm super happy that I got to do all of that. Because who's going to say, like, are you guys ever going to say, oh, I went to college, like, living half across the country away from you guys or anything. Like, I was out of LA. As much as I love California, I do really want to go back, but I did want to leave there for at least a year.
Here's another tough question. We told you for years, that the number one rule, especially from someone that went to college, is to not get a boyfriend your freshman year.
Right.
And I didn't. Sistine didn't.
But of course, Scarlet has to do her own thing.
She has to.
I wasn't planning on it, okay? I really was not planning on it. Coming into freshman year, I wanted to be single. I wanted to focus on myself. And there's been a couple of times where I was asked to be in more of a relationship and I've just turned it down.
Scarlett's like, I'm basically the bachelorette and the campus is my bachelor's.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Exactly. That's what I mean.
Well, let me, so Sophia and I, we always think that when you're starting such a new chapter of your life, it's important to figure yourself out.
We also like to push good things away.
That's true. Honestly, don't listen to us.
I know, but the number one thing I say to guys when they want to go like farther into like a more of a relationship, I go, if I can't take care of myself, how do you expect
no,
me to take care of
No, it's actually a problem because I feel like we all are the same way. I mean, like now you guys have boyfriends, but anything that is remotely starting to work out, even if it's like a little bit complicated, like maybe they're across the country or maybe they're a little older, whatever it is, we just shut it down. We go, you know, it's just better to sleep alone at night.
Yeah, I don't know why. The feeling. Well, no more so you. See, Scarlett and I have got it locked down. Sophia, how does it feel being the only single one in the group right now?
You know,
you are basically me.
I am you. I'm hidden. I was going to say something. What I said the other day last night to you and mom.
But I think Sophia.
A year.
What?
Oh, a year.
A year. It's been a couple years.
It's been a long winter.
She's been in hibernation.
She's been hibernating. Well, eating only almond butter.
And you know what?
She stocked up for the winter.
I am stocked up for the winter with almond butter. It feels fine, but you know what it is? Okay, this is the thing. When we're all single, I feel fine because you're alone and you're alone. But now, mom and dad are a couple.
So, dog.
You're mom and dad are
like, you're mom and dad a couple. Are dating. You're dating.
You're dating. All my friends are dating. Everyone.
Well, also.
And now.
No, this is funny. Sophia said that I heard her saying this to mom the other day and I was eavesdropping.
Why?
Wait, I'm so excited to hear this.
Because you complain about this all the time. And this is just to reinforce how single you are.
What?
Oh my God.
Sophia says to mom the other day, she goes, you know, I probably check Facebook at least once a week.
Oh, yeah.
And every time I check Facebook, I see about a whole group, maybe five posts of people getting engaged.
Everyone's
and
getting
I'm saying,
engaged.
What the hell? And Sophia's like, I'm sitting here.
I go.
She goes, my finger feels naked.
I go, what the hell?
She goes, I'm a size 7.
No. I just at least want like a cute promise ring or just like something.
Huh?
Or just at least like a
Sophia, you're not even talking to someone.
No.
Who are you?
Okay, let's get back to Scarlett's boyfriend. So why don't you tell us a little bit about him?
Okay.
Yeah.
We were both very shocked. We were both, I'm just as shocked as you guys. We are very shocked that we wanted to date freshman year. And I guess that I we kind of just bounce off each other really well. Like, we connected quickly. I really, really like him. Aww. And I think he feels the same
way. How did about he me. Ask you to be his girlfriend?
He asked, nothing special. Well, he wanted to take me out to dinner and ask then, but then we were both busy for the whole weekend. So he just goes, I wanted to take you out and do something more special.
Okay, so the thought was there.
The thought was there. I knew he wanted to, but he just asked then and there. And I didn't want like a grand asking, but it was nice. You know, I don't know why
I changed my mind, and I'm actually happy you found someone, because I think that when
I changed my mind.
I like you happy. This is why I changed my mind.
I was going to say that it's nice when you're feeling, what you were saying before in the episode, that you were feeling lonely and things like, it's hard transition when you don't have your person.
Yeah.
And I think that if you're doing that and you find someone mm-hmm. that is kind of in the same boat, he is not a cheater or a manho, and you know it's not going to be because look, dating in college, it is a lot because there's a lot of pretty girls, a lot of pretty guys, like it gets called a lot of temptation. Party. There's a lot of temptation. Yeah. And so let's just say it's a healthy relationship. Go in and you're
why
like,
not?
Yeah. Right. Yeah, if you are happy with someone and you've been seeing them for a minute and you don't want to be with anyone else or you're not even thinking about anyone else, then why not just do it? Is it the label that freaks you out so much? It's not really different. Like if you, right?
That's yeah, true. No, that's what I'm scared of.
I know you're scared of the label, but like if you're thinking and constantly seeing someone and you're going on dates and whatnot,
mm-hmm.
what is the point of just standing around there and just being afraid to take the next
step? Yeah, I agree. I think we're all the same when we don't like to just date casually. If we're going to take us out to dinner 5, 6, 7 times, it needs to be progressing somewhere. Like, I don't want this to just continue.
This poor boy had to deal with me because I was so confused and I didn't want to be in a relationship. And he knew that. But then I started liking him more and more and more throughout the weeks. So, but he was getting stressed out because he goes, okay, so do you want to go backwards or forwards? And I go, I think we should just take a step back. And then he goes,
Scott's like, I want to cha-cha slide to the left.
No. Actually. And then, no, yeah. And I go, let's just take a step back. He goes, what does that even mean at this point? I understand. Like, he goes, I will do whatever, like, what makes you feel comfortable and good. But, you know, I like how he respected my craziness because I am a lot.
Your timeline.
Yeah, I am a lot. I do respect
there's layers to all of us that take a lot of hammering. A lot
of chipping away.
So if someone can deal with that, then he is the person.
I'm so excited for when we all hang out in January and I get to fifth the wheel and I get to hear the freaking kissing noises. Does anyone not like the sound of
I'll tell you what. Sophia was very upset with me the other day. I was giving a kiss goodbye, if you will. And then right when the door closed, you made it a point to be so dramatic and say, that is the most disgusting sound ever.
Sophia, you haven't heard that sound in a minute.
And it's silent. I'll hear.
It's Sophia, you're just jealous because you're not hearing that sound or making it yourself. Hey, I have a question. Your phone's ringing, Sophia. Mm-hmm. Yeah, answer it. Love's calling. Are you gonna pick up? she just muted it.
She hung up on love.
Hey, I have a question, Scarlett, though, because you guys are planning to come to Los Angeles together in January. Are you going to let him meet the parents?
You know what's really funny? So I'm okay with this. My chair actually keeps squeaking. It's really annoying. So my
Larry wants was Abe Abin. Okay, let's ask that again. Just do that again. So you and your boyfriend are coming to Los Angeles in January.
Yeah.
Are you going to let him meet the parents?
Yes. But give it a second. Here's the thing. I want him to. He wants to. There's nothing. The only person that's holding back from meeting the parents. It's just a huge step.
It is a huge step.
It is a huge step. And I like where we're at right now.
You both are going to be introducing your guys for the first time to parents. Oh, yeah.
Me too.
Me too. Oh, wow.
We'll do it together so it softens the blow. But
you know what's... I'm going to be the goofy one. Hey, guys. You know, the icebreaker here.
Pouring the cocktail.
So if you're thinking shots in the background. Oh, nice to meet you.
No, I'm going to diffuse the bomb of mom asking 400 questions and dad speaking zero times.
Words.
Zero words.
Well, you know what?
But you know, actually, I have to say this. You know what's scarier for me than the parents? You guys. You two little devils. I am so nervous for him to meet you guys more than mom and dad. I know mom and dad will like him easily.
Well,
like,
oh, really?
Easy.
I'll tell
but you.
You
guys are a different breed. It's
well, it's
scary for me.
The thing is, like, your parents know you, but your sisters know you a different way.
Yeah.
And
I will tell you straight up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We will be, because we want the best for you. And we see through this generation's BS.
Mm-hmm.
But I think dad will like him because Sophia and I have said this since day one. Scarlett, I'm not going to lie, you're kind of dating dad. I know that sounds crazy to say, but the similarities between your boyfriend and your dad are uncanny. Like, for example, what does he wear?
He wears, I don't like the name of this top, but it's called a wife beater.
The white tank
top. With a chain and a backwards hat.
He's Italian.
Italian.
He's basically a meatball. Dad's a meatball
Staten
too.
Staten Island.
Long he's Island? Not from Staten Island
they're
or
both
Long
like,
Island.
Yeah, they're
okay,
both
he's stop saying that.
They're both like New York pigeons.
Hey, oh,
No, it's not. Okay, I do see kind of a resemblance between the two now that you say it.
And they both have three-letter names.
Sly. And- no. Got off. But that's, yeah.
She's like, I don't
want to say that I'm dating my dad. That's gross.
Okay.
That's creepy.
Okay, why don't we wrap up this episode? I thought we'd bring in a fun little game. And I thought it summarizes you quite well. It's a quiz that I'm going to give you. And it's going to tell us if you are a terrible sister or not.
Okay, what is... Where's
it's called the
fineness?
BuzzFeed. It's called the Terrible Sister Quiz. So I'm going to ask you some questions. And you're going to say whether you're guilty or innocent to doing that. Ready? Have you ever borrowed your sibling's clothes without asking?
Oh, guilty.
Guilty, okay.
Yeah.
Have you ever listened in on a sibling's
guilty.
Phone call? Okay, guilty.
Yeah,
have you ever bossed them around after your parents put you in charge?
Innocent. I've never had that power.
Yep.
Have you ever...
have
you ever read their diary?
Guilty.
Guilty too.
Yeah, guilty three.
Thank you, Sophia, for the personal entertainment about your breakup.
Excuse me?
It wasn't even from your last relationship. It was from like a, it was
See,
from
this
a
is
crush.
Why I don't write in a diary.
No, it was from like a crush in eighth grade Sophia had.
Look at her
it was
face.
Not
moving
like
on,
college.
Moving on.
It was an eighth grade crush.
Have
no,
you
I gotta
ever,
hide it better.
Have you ever saved, you need to put a lock on that shit.
I know. I write a lot.
Have you ever saved embarrassing photos of them to use for blackmail?
Oh, guilty. I think we all have like...
Have you ever exposed them for telling a lie or exaggerating something online?
Wait, online?
Have you ever exposed them for telling a lie or exaggerating something online?
Guilty.
Have you ever awkwardly hung around them and their friends waiting to be invited?
Guilty.
Oh my God. All the time. When you brought your guy friends from
you were
I was in love. I was in like my little Catholic long skirt.
Yeah,
from
you
middle
were
school.
You loved the attention.
I was running around after you guys.
Have you ever acted smug when your parents took your side?
Oh, guilty.
I mean, I think it's like the
You're
ultimate
gonna
win.
You're going to fail this quiz. Have you ever scratched them and left a fingernail scratch?
Guilty.
I know, I have.
Have you ever used their expensive beauty, hair, or skincare products without asking?
Yes, yesterday. Guilty.
Have you ever pulled their hair?
Guilty.
Yes.
Have you ever pretended to cry to make someone feel bad?
Guilty.
Have you ever sneaked into the room to steal... A hair elastic. That's a weird
Guilty.
Question.
Yeah, I do still
yeah,
want
yeah,
hair.
I feel like
I hear your hair elastics too.
Oh, you just, do?
Wait, are we just swapping the same?
Christine, I have all your hair ties and my dorm.
I knew it!
Remember the black one with the little gold at the end?
That's
yeah.
That's my favorite!
I know. It's in my dorm.
You are a terrible sister. so I've been looking for that one.
I see all my friends.
That's just a bad person. That's just theft.
Like, how nice. That's just theft. Like, they're big ones.
That's just theft.
I hate it when my friends use my hair ties.
You mean mine? Have you ever secretly recorded them doing something embarrassing on your phone?
I think you guys do it to me all the time.
Mostly Sophia.
Have you ever rubbed it in their face when you were allowed to do something they weren't?
Oh, guilty. I don't remember the last time, but I feel like I would.
Have you ever intentionally left hair on the shower wall just to annoy them?
Not to annoy them, but I do that all the time.
I guess no.
You leave hair on the shower wall?
I clean it up after.
Have you ever... She draws pictures with it.
Ew. That's what you sound like. I'm the biggest loser ever.
Oh my God. Okay. Have you ever fought over a mutual friend? No. Okay. Have you ever spied on them when they invited a romantic interest over?
Yes. Oh, yes. My God. I used to watch him in the gym when I wasn't there.
Yes. I did like to stalk Sophia's ex.
Wait, the funniest part is she had a photo of him on her screensaver before meeting him.
Yeah.
Knowing it was my boyfriend.
They have two more.
It was a Tumblr good day for me. Actually, a terrible day because he was not with me. Anyways,
have you
not
ever?
With me either, so it's okay.
This one is dark.
Rest in peace. No, she's alive.
This one,
the relationship.
Metaphorically, he's dead. Have you ever told them they were an accident?
You have to meet when you're younger.
I probably did. So innocent.
Scarlet, innocent.
And finally. Have you ever secretly idolized them but never let them know it?
Oh, guilty, 100%. I'm not going to make you guys too cocky.
Oh, wow, your results are in. You are the sister from hell. Okay, it says you are a terrible sister. You love nothing more than to push your siblings' buttons, steal their stuff, and get them in trouble.
To be honest,
these are general questions that I think
deep down,
you guys.
Somewhere in your cold heart, you have love for them.
I have deep love for all of you. That's why I cry every time I see you.
Well, I think ending it on that note is pretty perfect.
Yeah.
We are so happy you guys had the opportunity to meet her again and see her again. Because always when we do these episodes with Scarlet, it is always something you guys
enjoy. It feels very homey and comfortable.
Yeah,
I know. I just like love talking to you guys. I can do this even without the mics. And naturally, we do this all the time. We literally talk like this for hours in general. So it just feels so good to be sharing everyone. Like, I like showing everyone like our relationship, our dynamic, and everything.
Well, we love you, and this won't be the last time that you guys will see Scarlet.
Yeah,
on the
don't
show.
Miss me too much.
Make sure you follow her on social media at Scarlet Stallone on Instagram. Make sure you follow our podcast at Unwaxed Podcast on Instagram, TikTok, our YouTube, Twitter. Am I forgetting anything?
No, and we will see you guys next Tuesday.
Bye.
Bye.